The last section, section 9 of chapter 2, elasticity, is acoustic impedance. As you know, seismic waves are reflected in the Earth's interior if the structure is discontinuous. Typical examples are Mohorovicic discontinuity, 660 km discontinuity, and Coromandel boundary. Then an open question is, what condition the wave is reflected? In other words, what parameter is critical to judge reflectivity? The answer is acoustic impedance. If the acoustic impedance are largely different between adjacent medium, the wave is reflected. Then let us argue the reflection of elastic waves to obtain this conclusion in this section. Before talking about the seismic reflection, let us discuss about the energy of one-dimensional size elastic wave. So this is the real part of the wave equation. The displacement u is equal to the amplitude of the displacement u0 times cosine kx minus omega t, equation 2016 prime. Then the partial derivative of the displacement with respect to x is equal to minus k, the wave number, times u0 times sine kx minus omega t, equation 2.9.2, and the partial derivative of the displacement with respect to the time t is equal to omega, the angular frequency, times u0 times sine kx omega t, equation 2.9.3. Then the potential energy, namely the strain energy, up, is equal to 1 over 2 times the elastic constant e times the square strain squared. Therefore, the up is equal to e over 2 times the partial derivative of displacement u with respect to the position x squared, which is equal to e, the elastic constant e, times the angular wave number k squared plus the amplitude u0 squared divided by 2 times sine kx minus omega t squared. Therefore, which is equal to k squared u0 squared divided by 2 times 1 minus cosine 2 kx minus omega t over 2, equation 2.9.4. The kinetic energy uk is equal to 1 over 2 times the time derivative of the displacement u squared. Therefore, the kinetic energy uk is equal to rho over 2 times the partial derivative of the displacement with respect to the time t squared, which is equal to the density rho times the angular frequency omega squared plus times the amplitude u0 squared over 2 times sine x kx minus omega t squared, which is equal to the density rho times omega, the angular frequency omega squared times the amplitude u0 squared over 2 times 1 minus cosine 2 kx omega t over 2, equation 2.9.5. Then the total energy ut is equal to the potential energy UP plus the kinetic energy UK. So UT is equal to the potential energy this part and kinetic energy this part. So both term has the factor 1 minus cosine 2 times kx minus omega t divided by 2. Therefore, by combining these two terms, we have 1 over 2 times the elastic constant E times k squared plus rho, the density rho times the angular frequency omega squared times the amplitude u0 squared times 1 minus cosine 2 kx minus omega t over 2. Then we modify this formula to 1 over 2 square bracket the elastic constant E over the density rho times the angular wave number k over angular frequency omega squared plus unity 1 times rho times omega squared plus the amplitude u0 squared times 1 minus cosine 2 kx minus omega t over 2. E over rho is the velocity squared, because we learned velocity is equal to the square root of the elastic constant E over the density rho. And k over omega is inverse of the velocity v, because velocity v is equal to the frequency f times the wave length lambda. Therefore, this product is equal to the ratio of the angular frequency omega over the angular wave number k. Therefore, this inside of the square bracket is v squared times 1 over v squared. Therefore, they are cancelled and become unity 1. Then 1 over 2 times 1 plus 1. Therefore, this part become unity. Therefore, the formula becomes rho times squared angular frequency omega times the squared amplitude u0 times 1 minus cosine 2 times kx minus omega t over 2, equation 2.9.6. So the frequency kx minus omega is multiplied by 2 here. This means this is a wave, and this is the energy density. At the node, the energy density is zero, and anti-node position, the peak and valley, they are highest. Therefore, the frequency or the wavelength become half of the original wave. The wavelength of the energy density wave is half of the original length of the original length of the wave. Then we have seen that the average energy of the wave is proportional to the density rho and omega squared and the amplitude u0 squared. The total energy ut is proportional to 1 minus cosine 2 times kx minus omega t over 2. Therefore, it is not kept constant within a given volume of element. Energy at maximum あとはコサイン kx マイナスオメガ t イコールプラスマイナス1。then はコサイン 2kx マイナス2オメガ t イコールマイナス1。アンティノードでは、マキシマ。and エナジーズミニマムアットコサイン kx マイナスオメガ t is 0。or コサイン 2kx マイナス2オメガ t イコールプラス1。at node this energy is minimum. The energy is transferred by the movement of the node. So this high density position in the body is moving, which transfer the energy from one side to the other side. That transferred energy per unit time is proportional to the wave velocity v. So this green part, rho times omega squared times u0 squared, is proportional to the energy in one packet, and v is the velocity of the movement of this packet. Then, as a result, the transferred energy per unit time is proportional to the product of rho omega 2 u0 squared and velocity v, equation 2.9.7. Then let us consider the reflection of elastic wave between two media. This illustration shows the setting of this argument. The upper part is medium 1, and lower side is medium 2. The incident wave comes from upper side through the medium 1 and reflected or transmitted on the boundary between medium 1 and medium 2. The boundary of the medium 1 and medium 2 is defined as x equals 0, and x equals positive, x is positive in the downward direction. Then, this slide shows the explains the notation of the wave. U sub I is a displacement by the incident wave at point x and time t. U sub r x t is the displacement of the reflected wave at point x and time t. And u sub t x t is the displacement by the transmitted wave at point x and time t. U sub I0 is the amplitude of the incident wave. U R sub R0 is the amplitude of the reflected wave. U T0 is the amplitude of the transmitted wave. V1 is the velocity in the medium 1, and V2 is the velocity in medium 2. Then the displacement of the wave at the boundary must be equal in the medium 1 side and medium 2 side. So in the medium 1 side, the total displacement is the sum of the displacement of the incident wave and reflected wave at point x time t, which is equal to the displacement of the transmitted wave at x equals 0 and time t. Then we express this one as ui0 plus ur0 is equal to ut0. Then conservation of energy is rho1 times the density of the medium 1, rho1 times omega squared times ui0 squared times v1 is equal to rho1 times omega squared plus ur0 squared times v1 plus rho2 times omega squared times ut0 squared times v2. Why we have this equation is, first, we consider frequency is common among the incident wave and reflected wave and transmitted wave. And we consider the energy of the incident wave is delivered to a reflected wave and transmitted wave. Then we substitute equation 2.9.9, u sub I0 plus u sub R0 is equal to u sub T0 into the equation of the conservation of the energy 2.9.10. Then we have rho 1 times u I0 squared V1 is equal rho 1 u R0 squared V1 plus rho 2 times parenthesis open u I0 plus u R0 parenthesis closed squared V2 equation 2.9.11. In the previous slide, we have obtained this equation. This equation does not contain the amplitude of the transmitted wave. So we decompose this equation into this formula. Here, the this one is from this one. This one is from this one. And these three terms are from this one. Rho 2 is common, and V2 is common. And ui0 plus ur0 squared becomes this one, and 2 times ui0, ur0, and r0 squared is equal to 0. Then we divide this minus 2 times rho 2 v2 ui0 ur0 into two terms, and we add this black term minus ur0 rho 1 v1 ui0 ur0 two times. Then the first four terms have a factor of ui0, and the latter four terms have a factor of ur0. And the other part is inside the of these parentheses, rho 1 v1 ui0 minus rho 2 v2 ui0 minus rho 1 v1 ur0 minus rho 2 v2 ur0. And this one and this one are the same. As a result, this equation becomes the product of ui0 plus ur0. And parenthesis rho 1 v1 minus rho 2 v2 times ui0 minus parenthesis rho 1 v1 plus rho 2 v2 parenthesis close times ur0 equals 0, equation 2.9.12. Then the solution of this equation is, there are two solutions. One is ui0 plus ur0. This part is 0, or the latter part is 0. Then let us consider the first solution, ui0 plus ur0 equals 0. Then this is complete reflection, because ut0 is equal to ui0 plus ur0, which is 0. Therefore, no transmitted wave. And this is referred to as complete reflection. And the amplitude is minus with each other, which means the reflected waves have the same magnitude of the amplitude, but the opposite phase to the incident wave. Then let us consider the second solution. Rho 1 V1 minus rho 2 V2 times ui0 minus rho 2 V1, rho 1 V1 plus rho 2 V2 times ur0 is equal to 0. So in this case, the amplitude of the reflected wave ur0 is equal to rho 1 V1 minus rho 2 V2 divided by rho 1 V1 plus rho 2 V2 times ui0. Therefore, the amplitude of the reflected wave is proportional to the difference of PV between two media, PV1 V1 minus rho 1 V1 minus rho 2 V2. If the rho 1 V1 is smaller than rho 2 V2, then the phase become negative, because this upper side numerator become negative. Therefore, the phase is opposite. So this is as if the fixed end of the wave reflection, media 2 is stiffer and heavier. Therefore, it behaves as if a fixed end. The transmitted wave, the amplitude of the transmitted wave ut0 is equal to ui0 plus the ur0, which is rho 1 v1 minus rho 2 v2 divided by rho 1 v1 plus rho 2 v2 times ui0, which is equal to 2 times rho 1 v1 divided by rho 1 v1 plus rho 2 v2. Because rho 1 v1, rho 2 v2 are all positive, therefore the ut0, the amplitude of the transmitted wave is always the same, has always same sign with the incident wave. Therefore, phase of the transmitted wave and the incident waves are always the same. If the this rho 1 V1 and rho 2 V2 are equal, then the reflected wave become amplitude become 0, and the numerator and denominator of the transmitted wave is equal. Therefore, if the product of u1 v1 is equal to the product of the product of rho 1 v1 is equal to the product of rho 2 v2, then 100% of transmission. Thus, the Rho V is the essential parameter for the reflectivity and the transmissivity. Then, as we have already seen, it is referred to as acoustic impedance, Zs, which is equal to the product of the density rho and velocity v. Then, please let us consider why Zs is referred to as impedance. In the electricity, the impedance is the ratio of voltage to the current. Then, this means impedance is the ratio of the driving force to its results. The voltage is the force action to produce current. Then, result is the current. Then, the acoustic impedance, Zs, is the ratio of the stress to the particle velocity. So, we push the body and how the body part moves, how fast the part of the body moves. Then, we consider particle velocity, which is the partial differential of the displacement u with respect to time, which is equal to omega u0 times sine kx minus omega t by assuming the wave function is u equal u0 times cosine kx minus omega t. The stress is sigma is equal to the elastic constant E times the strain epsilon is equal to the elastic constant E times the partial derivative of the displacement u with respect to the x, which is equal to minus EK u0 sine kx minus omega t. So the acoustic impedance Zs is equal to, here let us have an absolute value, then sigma over the particle velocity, which is equal to, by forgetting the sine kx minus omega t, EK u0 over omega EK u0 over omega u0. Then we produce E over rho here, then rho appears here. Then K over omega remains. And we have already seen E over the elastic constant over the density rho is the phase velocity squared, and K over omega is inverse phase velocity. Therefore, this formula becomes the density rho times the phase velocity v, phase, equation 2.9.19. This is the reason rho v phase is referred to as acoustic impedance. Then please let us see the reflectivity at the mantle discontinuities. First is a 14 km discontinuity. The upper side of the across 14 km discontinuity, the density of it is 3.54 and the velocity is 8.91 km per sec. Then acoustic impedance is 3.15 times 10 to 7 kg per square meter second. The lower side, the density is 3.72 gram per cubic centimeter, and the velocity is 9.13 kilometer per second. Both of them are P wave. Then the acoustic impedance of lower side is 3.4 times 10 to 7 kilometer per square meter second. Therefore, reflectivity at the 14 kilometer discontinuity is 3.15 times 10 to minus 7 minus 3.40 times 10 to minus 7 divided by like this, then minus 3.7%. So about 4% reflection and overturn occurs. At 660 km discontinuity, the density above and below the 660, 3.99 and 4.38, and the velocity is 10.27 and 10.75. Therefore, acoustic impedance are 4.10 times 10 to 7 and 4.71 times 10 to 7. Then, acoustic impedance. From this acoustic impedance, the reflectivity is found minus 6.9%. Therefore, the 660 is a stronger discontinuity than 410 km discontinuity. Finally, let us summarize the phase shift and overall turn. Let me emphasize, no phase shift by the reflection and the transmission occurs because the reflectivity and transmissivity are both real numbers. Overturn occurs when the incident beam is from a low impedance, acoustic impedance side to the high acoustic impedance side. Therefore, because the shallower part usually is lighter and have a lower velocity compared to deeper region. Therefore, in the reflection from the upper side, the overturn occurs. But in the case of the underside reflection, like this case, seismic wave comes here and reflected from the underside of the seismic discontinuity and observed here. In this case, overturn does not occur. So this is the end of the section 9, acoustic impedance, in the chapter 2, elasticity. And this is the end of the chapter 2.